outside. Oh, man. Vanderpool, what's he thinking? Looks like it's his turn to beat on the conga drums here, using Rave's head. That cannot be good for a man's face. Of course, let me just remind all the fans that up next is our main event, six-man tag team matchup. It's going to be Brandon Moore, the Nature Boy, Steve Farrell, and Ashley Dunn against Ace Reed, Alex McConnell, and MT Wallet. And Rave with a crossbody right there. Guess that was his receipt from the earlier one that Vanderpool performed. And I'm having a difficult night here, so bear with me. Vanderpool sends him in the turnbuckle, clotheslines him. Tiger suplex! Too close to the ropes for the referee to make a count. He had him in a bridge. Vanderpool, what are you doing? He was just beating up the referee. I don't know if that was by intention or accident. Then again, I think referee dumbass is officiating this matchup. Poor bastard. Vanderpool with a hammer lock working on the arm. And then he just nailed his arm. Vanderpool just... he was just unloading, but Rave just counters him right here. Swinging neck breaker. 450 splash! And he's got a cover in on Vanderpool, but only a two. Some guys here tend to screw up their 450s, but Rave usually always hits his. Whenever I look at Rave, I see a guy who just loves to come out here. He loves to have fun. He loves to party. Because, you know, that's kind of what ravers do. That's the sort of the definition of raving. But I can also tell he loves to come out here and be an exciting all-around performer. And it would certainly do wonders for him to get to the finals of this Cruiserweight title tournament. Hurricanrana with some punches. Of course, we saw what happened. The finals of the TV title tournament have been says Rave again with the 450. This might be it. Two count only. But yeah. And Dan Van Vertigo is going to face Chris Cryptic in the TV title finals. And I'm still wondering what was up with the more unusually aggressive tactics that Chris Cryptic was taking against his tag team partner Greg Hurst in their matchup, as I don't know if Vanderpool yopped on the leg drop or what. He didn't yop on that, that was for sure. Nicely done. What's he chopping at? That was nice right there. Dragon Sleeper, but too close to the ropes to make any progress. Oh man. Sidewalk slam off the top rope. Oh wait, Vanderpool with a capture suplex! And man, he just nailed on Rave!
One, two, three!
He got him! Vanderpool. That's gotta be a sort of upset right there. Maybe he's finally on the way to getting up that ladder. He could end up being Cruiserweight Champion, because he's gonna face Chris Goodman. Fans, don't go away. Our main event is up next, and I'm being told through my headset, General Manager Destiny has some sort of announcement to me. Can't wait to hear this. Alright, it's time for our Falco main event. Six-man war here, and we got Alex McConnell on his way to the ring. And how about that announcement we just heard from Destiny, General Manager of Aftershock? Next week here on this program, we're gonna see two pick-your-poison matches involving the scam artist Hoovie and the Avenging Angel Shadow MC. And this is kind of like what we did with CJ Hawkins and MT Wallet back at Thursday Night Mayhem 1 in 07. And speaking of MT Wallet, there he is. But yeah, it's basically like that. So Hoovie is basically going to be picking Shadow MC's opponent. And Shadow MC is going to be picking Hoovie's opponent. And of course, we know with Hoovie, it's, he's got something on that sick mind of his. But Shadow MC, he's gonna be so subliminally pissed off with Hoovie that he's probably gonna, since he can't kick his ass, he's probably gonna wanna kick his butt. Since he can't kick his ass until Reformation, he might do something to kick his mind, basically. MT Wallet, the number one contender to the BYU Championship. Of course, he, like I said, he was involved in Pick Your Poison back in 07 during his war with Hawkins over the North American Championship. And right now he's involved in war with Steve Farrell over the BYU Championship. And they're going to go at it in a rematch from Dynasty at Reformation in a steel cage. And you want to talk about Reformation for a second. How about what happened earlier tonight with Ashley Dunn jumping this guy, Ace Reed? But then again, Ace Reed kind of had it coming since 2 weeks ago he ambushed Ashley Dunn when he was getting ready for a match. And earlier we heard Ace Reed whining and crying, and that he thinks Ashley Dunn is a coward. Well, weren't you the one who attacked first? I may be a little older than I was, but my memory hasn't failed me just yet, Mr. Reed. Last I checked, you were the one who drew first blood. So, stop acting like a punk-ass crybaby. But anyway, U.S. champ Brandon Moore on his way to the ring, the franchise for Aftershock. He's scheduled to meet Alex McConnell because Alex McConnell, he has a shot at the U.S. title. You know, I like to call Brandon Moore the franchise of Aftershock. It just wouldn't be the same here without this guy. But I think, I would certainly think that just as important as Brandon Moore being the franchise of Aftershock, is this guy right here carrying the ball as the BYU champion. Nashville, Tennessee, it's the Ninja Boy, Steve Farrell. Woo! Steve Farrell, he loves the whole idea of a steel cage match against MC Wallet at Reformation. I mean, he says it's on, and he's telling Wallet to be the man. Woo! You gotta beat the man. And brother, Steve Farrell is the man. And I'll tell you what. Steve Farrell,